LG went all in with the 18:9 display aspect ratio this year for its flagships. Both the G6 and the V30 employ the spec that's become incredibly trendy in 2017. The tall screens have only recently started to make their way to mid-rangers, though, and on that front LG was among the first to deliver, with the Q6. The device comes in rather compact dark gray cardboard box with prominent Q6 branding on the front, the Life's Good When You Play More logo on one side, and the regulatory label on the other. Opening the box up reveals the phone front and center, under which we find the charger, a USB cable, with micro USB on the phone side and a standard USB connector at the other end, and a pair of bundled earbuds. All of these accessories are white in color even for our black Q6, something which trips our OCD but you will probably be fine. The Q6 measures 142.5 × 69.3 × 8.1 mm, meaning it's supremely pocketable for its 5.5-inch screen size. It's 6.4 mm shorter, 2.6 mm narrower, and 0.2 mm thicker than the G6. It weighs 149 grams, which makes it about average in terms of feel. Definitely not too light, but also not heavy enough that it becomes a burden to handle. Compared to the G6, it's 14 grams lighter. From this point of view, the Q6 is a different beast depending on which part of it you're glancing at. The front screams G6, it's very much like a slightly smaller iteration of that phone, aside from the less prominent LG branding hiding in the bottom bezel. The 7000 series aluminum frame has a similar feel too, though it is slightly more rounded towards the screen and the back. The Q6 packs the earpiece above the screen in the smallish top bezel, where the 5MP front camera and the proximity and light sensors reside too. The bottom bezel only serves as the setting for the pretty subdued LG logo. The LG Q6 has a 5.5 inches IPS LCD touchscreen with 2160×1080 resolution, making for 442 ppi density. It's protected by a sheet of Gorilla Glass 3, and like any LCD it has a standard RGB pixel pattern. The Q6 sports Qualcomm Snapdragon 435 chipset, which comes with an integrated X9 modem, that LG has specced with maximum theoretical peak download, upload speeds of 300–100 Mbps. Of course, in order to experience anything close to either of those numbers your network needs to support carrier aggregation in both directions, and you should be in an area with amazing signal, and connected to a cell site that's not overrun with users. The Q6 runs Android 7.1.1 Nougat, with LG's own UI layer plastered on top. If you've used an LG device this year you're probably familiar with what this looks like, but let's dive in nevertheless. The Snapdragon 435 chipset that powers the LG Q6 is definitely placed squarely in the lower mid-range segment, and the way it performs in benchmarks reflects this, unsurprisingly. The SoC has an octa-core Cortex-A53 CPU clocked it up to 1.4 GHz. An Adreno 505 GPU is in charge of graphics. Depending on whether you buy the Q6A, Q6/Q6+, you will get 2/3/4 GB of RAM. The Q6 you're located you might not get a choice and only have one model available. Our unit is single SIM for what it's worth. The Q6 managed to score a good mark in our standardized loudspeaker test. This puts it on par with the G6, interestingly. That said, the output sounds quite metallic when you go all the way up to maximum volume, and you shouldn't expect any significant level of bass at any point. You also need to keep in mind that this speaker's position on the back of the phone is a pretty rare sight in this day and age, and so if you want to put the handset on a flat surface, the sound will be muffled. LG's Bundle Gallery app has an albums view that you're taken into once you load it up. This will automatically create an album for camera shots, downloaded content, and screenshots. You can choose a preferred album, create new ones, and pick the sort order to either be newest first or oldest first. When inside an album, you can pinch zoom to fit more thumbnails on the screen, or use the zoom out gesture for less, You won't get fewer than 3 thumb columns though, or more than 6. There's no dedicated video player, you launch videos from the gallery or the file browser. You get controls for playback speed and a GIF maker included, 5, 10, or 15 seconds length. LG has decided to go with a 13MP f/2.2 shooter on the back, which has 1/3 of an inch sensor size and 1.12 micrometers pixels. Not the largest aperture we've ever seen, definitely, also not the biggest sensor or pixel size. OIS is missing too. All of that is code for this is not a flagship snapper. Or is it? Aside from the differing aperture and lack of image stabilization, the specs of this camera are intriguingly similar to those of a G6's not wide-angle unit. How does it perform, though? Find out in our testing below. The LG Q6 records video in 1080p at 30fps. You can also choose 720p, or an 18.9 inches high T-labeled mode that results in 1440 by 720 videos. By this point you may have already gathered that the Q6 is meant to be a mini sibling to the G6, with very similar looks, at least on the front, but lesser specs and a lower price. Although not explicitly stated in the marketing materials, this seems to be the way LG wants to position the device, even the 6 in its name implies it. The Q6 is a modern-looking mid-ranger, a quality owed mainly to the display's aspect ratio and slim surrounding bezels, for people who aren't into spending money on flagship-level specs.